We were invited down here by the NFL to cover the Super Bowl, but thank God that NFL had a desire to bring justice because they're trying to make change. I'm glad I'm here. I'm representing VMH Magazine, but personally, I'm representing myself, Gary Jones, Advocate for Justice. And we're going to have a lot of players, former players and current players, that come across this carpet here in about another hour. The main player, he will start off around 6 o'clock, Antoine Bolton. Some of you all might know Antoine Bolton. He played with Florida State. He went on to play with the Phoenix Cardinals. Then I think he ended his career with the Buffalo Bills. Now, he's been doing groundbreaking work for a long period of time. While he was working, while he was playing with the NFL, he was also doing humanitarian work. He went overseas to do humanitarian work. He did humanitarian work here. He not only played the game on the outside, he created the game, a change.
The criminal justice system, social justice, why is that so important to you?
Because I see the effects that it has on communities like where I come from. Have family members affected by it, friends, you name it. So I think it's only right that having a platform that I have, that I've been blessed to have, it's only right that I speak out about it.
And we're grateful to you for that. Now, can you let us know how effective your program has been and the name of your program and how folks can get involved?
The name of the program is the Players Coalition. Okay. Tonight we're here with Cafe Momentum, along with Inspiring Change for the NFL. And over the last couple of years, it's been very effective. We've been able to see change through policy throughout a couple different states. But for us, I feel like we're just getting started. The work that we're doing, we're trying to bring people together because, you know, you can make a difference on your own, which is something we've been able to do individually with our own personal foundations over, I think for me, it's been the last 16, 17 years. But when you partner with people, I think your impact is a lot greater. So I think that's what we're trying to do, bring people who have like minds, who want to see our criminal justice system change. Bring them people together and have them impact this world.
And I want you to know, and I'm pretty sure all of us agree, that we're grateful for your efforts and so many communities for that as well.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Thinking about it on the surface and thinking about, you know, first of all, the kid's going to go right back to the same house, street, neighborhood, school, poverty. But as I kept thinking about it more and more, I started to realize, you know, his life was dictated by choices that were made for him before he was ever born. And as I thought about 16-year-old him and 16-year-old me, I realized that my life was dictated by the same choices. Choices that involve the color of your skin, the socioeconomic class you're born in, the part of town you're born in, the resources you have access to. And neither one of us had a choice in those matters. They were handed to us, and there was nothing that I ever did to earn the privilege and opportunities that I had in life. And I thought that's not fair and that's not the world I want to live in. And that pushed me to continue working with the juvenile department and eventually opening Cafe Momentum.